Good morning, everyone. How are you today?
Hi.
Fine.
You?
I'm fine, thank you. Okay. Thank you, Gabriel, for turning on your camera. Okay.
Good morning, Miss.
Good morning, Gabriel. Okay, I will start this class talking about the task. Many people didn't send the activity. Muchas personas no mandaron la actividad. ¿Qué pasó? Voy a nombrar solo las que sí mandaron. I will check the people that sent the activity. Mandó Diego Alegría, Jean-Pierre, Benjamín Gutiérrez, Juan Jorquera, Karim Yanquitru, Juan José López, Antonia Montero, Sofía Orellana, Alicia Rebeco, and Catalina Troncoso. What happened with the rest? ¿Qué pasó con el resto?
Hoy día la mando sin falta, ¿no?
Ajá, ok.
¿Hay plazo todavía o no?
Yes, you can send it. Send it this week. Mándela esta semana, ok? Send it this week.
Ok.
Mm-hmm. Yes, because you have to complete that task. Hello, Benjamin. Ok.
Vamos a jugar hoy día.
What? Are we going to play? Yes, are we going to play, but at the end of the lesson.
Hoy día en la revancha, ¿verdad?
Yes, the revenge. That's true. Yeah, remember that the game is about the content that we studied last class. Okay, do you remember the last class lesson? What was the topic about? What was the lesson about? Do you remember the topic of our lesson?
Escuchamos un listening de los derechos humanos.
Okay, yes. We listened to an audio about human rights. That's true. Okay. I will start with a video, 1 minute video. So I need you can pay attention to this video, okay? Okay, this is the video. So tell me if you listened, please.
Human rights. What are human rights? Well, human rights are the values which keep society fair, just, and equal. They protect children, the elderly, people in care, victims of domestic violence, people with mental health problems, religious groups, teachers, soldiers, and yes, prisoners. They protect all of us. They protect you. Our human rights are protected by law. That means we can do something if our rights are attacked. But not everyone loves human rights. Some want to water them down, even scrap them. Our rights are under threat, so it's time to get educated. Societies used to be controlled by all-powerful rulers who could be horribly unjust. Kings only gave rights to people they liked. Over thousands of years, people fought for equality, and with every hard-won right came new laws that improved how we lived. But in the 20th century, brutal dictators came to power. They ruled by fear, like the kings of the past. Those hard-won rights, they were dismantled on an unimaginable scale. After World War II, the democracies got together and said, never again. They created a simple document setting out the basic rights we all need to live a dignified life. The European Convention puts rights, not rulers, at the heart of our society. Like the right to life, to liberty, to free speech. Then, in 1998, Parliament passed the Human Rights Act, which made our human rights part of UK law. This means public bodies like hospitals and schools must respect our rights, and if they don't, we can go to our local court to enforce them. Now, because of human rights, patients in hospitals must be treated with compassion. Journalists cannot be forced to reveal their sources. Soldiers must be given proper equipment. Gay people have to be treated equally, and the police cannot keep our DNA forever if we're innocent. We have to be treated fairly, at work, at home, in school, anywhere, everywhere. Our human rights are hard won. They're part of our British heritage. We are proud of them. If we lose them, vulnerable people will pay the biggest price. Know your rights. Celebrate them. Protect.
Okay. So we are going to watch it again. So please pay attention to the video.
Human rights. What are human rights? Well, human rights are the values which keep society fair, just, and equal. They protect children, the elderly, people in care, victims of domestic violence, people with mental health problems, religious groups, teachers, soldiers, and yes, prisoners. They protect all of us. They protect you. Our human rights are protected by law. That means we can do something if our rights are attacked. But not everyone loves human rights. Some want to water them down, even scrap them. Our rights are under threat, so it's time to get educated. Societies used to be controlled by all-powerful rulers who could be horribly unjust. Kings only gave rights to people they liked. Over thousands of years, people fought for equality, and with every hard-won right came new laws that improved how we lived. But in the 20th century, brutal dictators came to power. They ruled by fear, like the kings of the past. Those hard-won rights, they were dismantled on an unimaginable scale. After World War II, the democracies got together and said, never again. They created a simple document setting out the basic rights we all need to live a dignified life. The European Convention puts rights, not rulers, at the heart of our society. Like the right to life, to liberty, to free speech. Then, in 1998, Parliament passed the Human Rights Act, which made our human rights part of UK law. This means public bodies like hospitals and schools must respect our rights, and if they don't, we can go to our local court to enforce them. Now, because of human rights, patients in hospitals must be treated with compassion. Journalists cannot be forced to reveal their sources. Soldiers must be given proper equipment. Gay people have to be treated equally, and the police cannot keep our DNA forever if we're innocent. We have to be treated fairly, at work, at home, in school, anywhere, everywhere. Our human rights are hard won. They're part of our British heritage. We are proud of them. If we lose them, vulnerable people will pay the biggest price. Know your rights. Celebrate them.
Okay. So, according to the video that we saw, we are going to complete an activity. Okay, according to what you have watched in the video, complete the following activity. Here you have 8 sentences with its corresponding definition. So you have to complete number 1 to 8 from A to H. How do you complete? Human rights are?
H, the values that keep society fair, just, and equal.
Yes, very good. Thank you, Alicia. Human rights are the values, yes. Number 2, what human rights protect?
Tengo.
E, they protect children. Can you read, Camila? ¿Puedes leer?
They protect children, the elderly, people in care, victims of domestic violence.
Very good, thank you. Number 3, our human rights are protected. Which letter?
A. By law.
A. By law, right? Yes, by law. Very good. Number 4, societies used to be controlled by which letter?
F.
Which one?
F.
F.
A powerful F. rule.
Okay.
Who yes. Hold, be cruel and unjust.
Very good. Yes, very good. Number five. After World War II.
B.
B.
B. Who can read?
The
democracies got together and said never again. Never again.
Never again. Yes. Thank you. Number six, the European Convention. European Convention. Which letter?
B.
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 V.
Mm.
Parliament passed the Human Rights Act. I
or
think
C?
It's, yeah, that it's C. The European Convention puts rights, not rulers, at the heart of society. Yes. Number seven, in 1998, this is about British, okay? In 1998, which letter? We have D and G, I think. Which one, D or G?
D?
D, right? Can you read, Gabriel?
Parliament passed the Human Rights Act.
Okay, very good. And the last one, number eight, we have to be treated fairly.
G.
G, right? Where? In which places? At work? At home,
in a school, anywhere.
Anywhere. Yes, we have to be treated fairly anywhere or everywhere we go. Thank you. Okay, let's continue. So our objective for this lesson, our goal is to talking about human rights and its importance. Okay, we are going to talk about human rights again, because it's a very important content. Okay, this was our task, and I would like to check it with your own ideas. What do you write in this activity? So letter A, what do you think is the most important human right and why? So who can tell me what you wrote in letter A? The most important human right is? What do you write here?
I think that all humans' rights are important, but respect must be depend because today there is still a lot of discrimination.
Okay, thank you. Another one. Another answer. ¿Alguien más que escribió algo diferente que Alicia? ¿Alguien que hizo la actividad que nos nombré al comienzo? Fueron muy pocos. Who can tell me? What do you write here? Yes, Alicia, I can. Okay, Camila. But for example, which human rights do you think is the most important? ¿Cuál creen que es el más importante? You can tell me, I don't know, health, freedom, I don't know. What do you think? Education, health, because I saw that some of you wrote about health, other about freedom. What do you think? Which is the most important for you? This is personal. This is about you. What do you think about the most important human right? Benjamin, for example, or Gabriel, what do you think is the most important human right for you?
Freedom?
Freedom? Why freedom? Why do you think is freedom the most important for you? ¿Qué cree que será la libertad? What do you think? If you want, you can talk in Spanish. Okay. Freedom and care to children, says Camila. Okay. Let's continue with letter B. What is, in your opinion, the most neglected human right? Neglected, descuidado, el que no está tan protegido, quizás. And why? Which one do you think is the most neglected? So here you have the most neglected human right is. So what do you think?
Discrimination.
Sorry, Alicia?
Discrimination. La de discriminación.
Okay, discrimination. Why do you think is discrimination the most neglected?
In English?
Yes, if you want. Of course, I think you want. You can do it.
Because today, still many people who judge the rest by their religion. Gustos, etc.
Okay, likes. Okay, yes. So maybe people are discriminated because thinking differently, right? Because we think different to the rest. Freedom of expression, says Camila, is the most neglected. So we are not allowed, maybe, to express what we think. Okay, let us see. What are the main limitations of human rights today? What do you think is the main limitation? ¿Cuál será la limitación más grande de los derechos humanos hoy día? Which one do you think?
Que hay leyes antiterroristas para defender los derechos humanos, pero que al fin y al cabo lo único que hacen es pasar a llevar más derechos humanos.
Okay, and what do you think should be done? ¿Qué deberíamos hacer to strengthen the international protection? ¿Qué deberíamos hacer para protegerlos? Antonia says abuse of power. Mm-hmm. Yes, I think so. Abuse of power as well. ¿Qué podríamos hacer para protegerlos? Para fortalecerlos. What do you think? Camila says personas que no creen en los derechos, no los respetan y quieren arrebatarlos, deberían tomarse las cosas con justicia. Okay, yes. Thank you, Camila. So of course, human rights are protected by law, but sometimes, the law doesn't work very well. No me digas quién no respeta los derechos ajenos. Right. Yeah. Human rights are a very important part of society, but sometimes it is not so protected by law, right? What about D? What can we do against the violations of human rights? ¿Qué podemos hacer en contra de los derechos, de la violación de los derechos humanos? What do you think? What we can do? We can, we as citizens, nosotros como ciudadanos o como personas de parte de un país, ¿qué creen que podríamos hacer en contra de la violación de los humanos de parte de nuestra, parte nuestra? What do you think?
¿Quiénes las violan?
Protesting.
Sorry?
Protesting.
Protesting. So we have to protest against our human rights. We have to protect in the street, for example. What do you think?
A quienes violan los derechos humanos, en vez de solo meterlos presos, ayudarlos con una con rehabilitación, trabajo voluntariado, etcétera, para que puedan salir a la sociedad.
Okay, yes, that's a good idea. Thank you, Alicia. Call a demonstration, says Antonia. Okay, maybe to show the most important human rights, because we have many human rights, right? And demonstrate them, how they work, what is its real importance, right? Because maybe people don't know what are human rights. And what about E? Look at your own country. Do you think human rights are promoted and protected where you live? What do you think? Are protected here in Chile? Are human rights protected? Yes or no? Or so so?
So so.
So so. Why? Why do you think it's like in the middle?
At present, human rights are being carried out in specific areas, justifying them with silly excuses. For example, to defend dead Chileans from criminals, more people are tortured. In the context of the social outbreak or the fight in Araucanía with the Mapuches, or the LGBT community discriminated against because the Bible says.
Okay, thank you, Liz. Yes, here the, we have like Mapuche, issue, which is very important, right? In the Araucanía, gays and lesbian societies are not so protected here, and many other people. Camila says, no son protegidos porque durante el estallido social y todos los días en el Sename los derechos no son protegidos. What about Sename? Yes, Sename, children. Children are not protected, are violated. Their human rights maybe are violated. In Sename occurs a lot of abuse against children, and that's very sad. What can we do in Sename, for example? Yeah, that's true, Camila. Change the system. And how, ¿y cómo cambiamos el sistema? How do you think can we change that system?
Lo más importante primero hoy día es darse cuenta que esos niños existen. Okay. Porque la actualidad es un problema de alguien más. Pensemos, dejémosle ese problema al siguiente. Entonces, claro, darnos cuenta que ellos existen y hay que hacer algo. Una vez, ya después de ver que realmente existen, empezar a cambiar, castigar a quienes constantemente están violando sus derechos, darle más posibilidades, etc.
Okay, yes, that's true. Thank you, Alicia. Camila says, protestando y manifestando el descontento. ¿Ustedes creen que a través de las protestas nosotros hemos logrado cosas? What do you think about?
Sí. Yes. Históricamente, los mayores cambios se hacen tras protestas. Porque lamentablemente en esta sociedad las cosas pacíficas no se toman en cuenta.
Yes, that's true. Okay. Thank you for sharing your thoughts. Las personas que no han hecho esta actividad deben hacerla, mandarla. Recuerden que esto es personal. Por lo tanto, aquí lo que mencionó Alicia, Gabriel, o Benjamín, o Camila o Antonia, son personales, son cosas de ellas, de ellos. ¿Okay? Entonces yo necesito que las demás personas, que fueron muchos, no han mandado su actividad, la hagan. Por favor, me la manden esta semana. Son solo 5 preguntas. Okay, thank you. Let's continue. Our objective was talking about this one, talking about human rights and its importance. That's our goal for this class, talking about human rights and its importance. Okay, so read this extract. Read this text and answer the questions. This is in page 120 from your book. Si lo quieren buscar en su libro, está en la página 120. Okay. But here you also have it. You're welcome, Alicia. Okay. So read the text and answer these 2 questions. What human rights is it about? And number 2, do you agree with the paragraph? Voy a aprovechar de pasar lista. Diego Alegría. Diego Alegría, ¿estás? Answer me, please. Present, okay. Pia Allende. Milay Caroca. Michelle Díaz. Michelle. Alejandra Donoso.
Presente.
Ignacia Donoso.
Presente.
Jean-Pierre Faundes.
Presente.
Ah, okay, thank you, Javiera. Joaquín Gorigoitia.
Presente, Miss.
Sebastián Huenul.
Presente, Miss.
Sofía Guerra.
Presente, Miss.
Benjamín Gutiérrez.
Presente.
Carlos Guzmán. Juan Jorquera.
Presente, Miss.
Javiera Leiva.
Presente.
Karim Yanquitru.
Presente, Miss.
Juan José López.
Presente, Miss.
María Fernanda Merino.
Presente, Miss.
Gabriel Miranda.
Presente, Miss.
Antonia Montero. Luis Núñez.
Presente, Miss.
Michael Núñez.
Presente, Miss.
Francisca Ordóñez.
Presente, Miss.
Sofía Orellana.
Presente, Miss.
Paolo Pavés.
Presente, Miss.
José Peña.
Presente, Miss.
Javier Pino. Delia Quintero. Ahí está. Fabián Ramírez.
Presente, Miss.
Alicia Rebeco.
Presente, Miss.
José Ríos. Gabriel Riveros.
Presente, Miss.
Diego Rodríguez.
Presente, Miss.
Noelia Soto. Selenia Torrealba. Fernanda Torres.
Presente.
Catalina Troncoso. Dante Valdés. Ah, ya me dijeron. Valentina Valdivia.
Presente.
Héctor Valenzuela.
Presente.
Benjamín Venegas.
Presente, Miss.
Camila Vidal.
Presente, Miss.
Lisette Vivanco.
Presente.
Catalina Troncoso está. Ah, ya, sí. Sí, por eso es que te vi entrar y te... Por eso te preguntaba ya. Gracias. Ok, next. Okay, so what human right is it about? What is the human right that this text refers to? Which is?
Okay.
The right to?
Education.
Education, right? The right to education. Do you agree with the paragraph? ¿Está de acuerdo con el párrafo? Yes or no? Yes, I agree, or no, I disagree.
No, because the education is not the unique right.
Okay, it's not the unique right. Okay, what do you think about the rest? What do you think? ¿Alguien más que me quiera decir si está de acuerdo o no? ¿Qué me puede resumir el texto así a grandes rasgos? What is the text about? ¿Qué dice? ¿Dice de qué trata el derecho? ¿Cuál es la responsabilidad? ¿Cuál es la obligación? ¿Qué se refiere este? Este derecho.
Que todos tienen derecho a una educación básica, aunque sea.
Okay. Includes a responsibility, it says, to provide basic education for individuals. And also, it encompasses the obligations of the students to avoid discrimination at all levels of the educational system. Okay, this is the right. We have the right to be educated. Okay. Look at the human rights below. How will you rank them from 1 to 7 and why? ¿Cómo lo podríamos? Tenemos 7 acá. We have 7 human rights. How will you rank them? We have the human right of trust, justice, love, rule of law, peace, prosperity, and dignity. What do you think? Which one do you think is the first one for you?
Dignity?
Why dignity?
Because all people have minimum dignity.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Here you have, because I can see this is the most important human right, or because this human right is not so protected. Okay. Todos merecen dignidad como mínimo. Okay. Which one is for you the second one? Another, necesito que otra persona me pueda contestar. Gabriel Miranda, for example. Which one is for you the first one or the second one? Jan says number two, justice. Why justice number two? Jean-Pierre. What do you think is justice number two for you? For those who do not respect the laws. Okay. Okay, thank you. What about number three? We have, so for example, we have a dignity, then we have justice. According to you, what is number three for you? What could be number three? You can write in the chat if you want. You can say me in Spanish. Lisette, Benjamin Venegas, what do you think? Justice, I also think is necessary since that has to do a little with others such as peace and dignity. Okay, thank you, Antonia. Yes. So we have yes, I don't know. Are you sleeping? ¿Están durmiendo? Chicos, pueden contestar en español. Okay, I'm trying to do it in English because this is an English class. Estoy tratando de hacerlo en inglés porque esta es una clase de inglés y para que se vayan acostumbrando. La idea es que vayamos usando el inglés en la clase, aunque sea pedacitos. Aunque nos cueste un poquito. Aunque digamos Spanglish. Yeah, but the idea is to talk in English. Number three, rule of law. Okay. Why do you think rule of law is number three? Jean-Pierre, what do you think? And which one do you think is the number seven? Okay, for security. Thank you, Jean-Pierre. Which one do you think is number seven from this list? We have seven human rights here. Of course, we have more, but which one? Rule of law, number seven, Alicia? Okay. So we think that dignity is number one, then we have justice, and maybe rule of law is number three or number seven for others. It's up to you. Of course, this is up to you. ¿Dónde pondrían peace and love? In which place? Peace and love. In which number? From one to seven. The human right of peace. Camila? ¿En qué lugar pondrían? Okay, four and five place. Okay, Camila says, primero paz, and then we have love. Okay, yes. Very good, thank you. Thank you for sharing. Aquí la idea es que ustedes completen con sus ideas. La idea es que usted vea los siete derechos humanos y los vaya completo. De 4 a 6 por ahí, dice Antonio, ok. And peace in number 3. 4 peace, 7 love. Ok, yes. Esto es obviamente individual. Usted los pone en el ranking que usted quiera. Si usted considera que love es el número 1, lo coloca. Y, pero tiene que siempre especificar por qué cree que ese es el más importante. Ok. So let's click in the following link and complete this activity. Les voy a compartir un link. Oops. Acá. quiero que entren ahí a ese link y a ver si alcanzamos a hacer en 2 minutitos esta actividad. Okay, the idea, sorry, the idea is that here you have a list of human rights. You have freedom, peace, equality, dignity, hope, love, education, prosperity, justice, food, religion, and speech. No, no debiese pedirle que descargue porque es una aplicación directa. Es como entrar al link y... Lo que pasa es que Jamboard es parte del Gmail, no sé si lo han visto. ¿Ya? Pero si ustedes introducen Gmail, está Jamboard ahí. No debiesen pedirle que le descargue. Ya. Choose one of the human rights and write a definition or what you understand about it. Ya, aquí va a elegir uno de los human rights que tiene ahí usted. Y va a elegir aquí, si usted se fija acá al ladito, dice nota adhesiva, like a posit. ¿Sí? Posit, y ahí usted elige un color. Y escribe, elija un human right y escriba lo que usted entiende por ese human right o una definición suya. Okay? Puede ser, could be in Spanish, could be in English and Spanish, or could be in English. Ya, o sea, ahí trate, ojalá hacerlo en inglés, pero si no alcanzamos, si no podemos hacerlo en inglés, lo hacemos en Spanish. Ya. Ah, ya, me entiendo. Ya, chicos. Vamos, un minuto para hacer esta actividad. Elija uno de los nota adhesiva y escriba del... Bueno, si no puede entrar al link, hágalo por el chat y me lo escribe. Ya, no hay problema.
¿Qué había que hacer?
Elegir uno de los human rights que tiene ahí la imagen y escribir una definición o lo que usted entiende por ese human right. ¿Ya? Tiene freedom, peace, equality, dignity. También le pide descarga a Jamboard, qué raro. Ya. Ya, si no puede entrar, hágalo por el chat, ¿ya? Love. Todos los seres humanos tenemos derecho y libertad de amar a quien queramos. Ok, very good, Camila. Puede ser, Juan José, puede ser que es porque está en computadora. No veo ningún post-it. Aún. ¿Lo están usando? ¿Están escribiendo las personas que están en el... ¿En el Jamboard o no? Justice, las mismas oportunidades, derechos y castigos para todos por igual. Nadie está exento a la ley ni a la justicia. Ok, good.
Igual la mayoría aquí estamos haciéndolo por celular, entonces como sí, es esperable que todos lo contesten por chat.
Ya, bueno, no importa. Voy a esperar un minuto y si no... lo hacemos por el chat nomás. La idea es que en realidad esta actividad es como bien dinámica, si no la dejamos ahí pendiente. Ya, pero ya igual he recibido ya. La idea es que acá usted escriba una definición chica, cortita, así como en 2 líneas, lo que entiende. Dignity, we can all stand on our own 2 feet and take on responsibilities, ok. Justice, all people merece justice independent, the social, economic, races and gender, ok. Thank you. Good. Okay, I will stop sharing. The equality, all people are equal and have the same opportunities. Paz, dejar la violencia de lado, ponerse a la guerra y poder vivir en un más digno y de felicidad. Merece, deserve, probably deserve. Freedom, we all deserve freedom regardless of religion, gender, or other equality. Okay, good. Very good. O sea, independiente, independent. Conté al final la lista. Okay, I will stop sharing this because it's almost time for finishing. And I want to continue with the class. Okay. Gracias por compartir eso. La idea es que ustedes sepan definir los human rights, okay? Okay, now it's time for Kahoot. I don't know if I were... Antes de terminar, quiero terminar con Kahoot, pero quiero dejarle la actividad antes. Yeah, this is, you have to send it until June 16. Hasta el próximo miércoles se envía esta actividad. Choose a human right you want to talk about and look for information. Escoja un derecho humano del que quiera usted hablar y busque información. You have to talk about what it is about, what does this human right, and what you think is the real importance of this human right in society and why. Entonces, ¿de qué trata? Definición. ¿Qué hace este derecho humano? ¿En qué ayuda? ¿En qué aporta a la sociedad? ¿Cuál cree usted que es la real importancia de este derecho humano en la sociedad y por qué? O sea, esas tres preguntas me las responde. Dos opciones, record your voice o video. O sea, solamente se graba voz o se quiere grabar video. Ya, sí, para las personas que a lo mejor no son tan vergonzosas, can record a video. Ya, esto no podría durar más de 2 minutos. O sea, yo creo que 2 minutos es enough. Ok. We are all equal and have all the same human rights. Okay, thank you, Diego. Este es el criterio. Todos, all questions are answered in a full way. The speech is just in English. The speech contains appropriate vocabulary and grammar rules. And the speech is heard without problems. Este es el criterio. Yo se los voy a mandar ya para que lo tengan. Se los voy a mandar a sus correos para que lo revisen. Ya, esto se manda hasta el próximo miércoles 16, junto con la actividad escrita que tiene que mandarla esta semana sí o sí. ¿Ya? ¿Alguna duda con lo que tiene que hacer? Para terminar con el Kahoot, a ver si es que alcanzamos y no me cortan el son. Porque ya te pasa. Ya chicos, vamos al Kahoot. Voy a dejar de compartir. Y voy a ir al... Entren al Kahoot. ¿Y a dónde está? Uy, no sé dónde está el... No. Ahí está el Kahoot. Ahí debiese estarles compartiendo ya el pin. Ahí está. 376-02. 300-7602. Y la semana, Joaquín. Ya vi que algunos no pudieron entrar al Jamboard. No sé qué pasó. Pero es una aplicación del Gmail. Qué raro. Para que alcancemos. Ya, si no alcanzamos, chicos, hacemos esta actividad en la próxima clase, ¿ya? Ya, voy a empezar con los que entraron o con los que pudieron entrar. What was the topic of our last lesson? Conditionals, present simple, or human rights? human rights, right? Yes. Fernanda? True or false? Right is something that all humans have in society?
Mi, solo me sale verdadero y falso.
Sí, que esté verdadero o falso. Yo les leo la, la oración. Right is something that all humans have in society. True. Sí, Fernanda, number three, verdadero o falso. Responsibility is something that we must assume as a retribution to our rights. Sí, Fernanda. True or false? The concept of human right is recent. ¿Es reciente? True or false? False, no es reciente. Fernanda sigue primera. Number five. When did the human rights were declared? 1848, 1948, or 1498? 1948, yes. Fernanda sigue. Number six, verdadero o falso. Freedom of expression is one of the rights. True or false? Let's see. True. Alicia. Seven. Freedom of slavery is not a right. True or false? False. Es un derecho. Karin, number last one. We cannot have the freedom of movement and residence. True or false? It was false. Sí tenemos el derecho de movimiento, ¿cierto? Vamos a ver los lugares. Alicia y Rebeca, number third place, second place, Fernanda, first place, Karin, Benja y Michael, number four and five. Okay. Ya, chicos. Muy bien. Agradezco la participación del día de hoy. Cuídense mucho. Por favor, enviar las preguntas que no han enviado algunos y mandar el video o la voz. Ya, si tiene problemas, me consulta. Yo les voy a mandar la actividad a sus correos para que las tengan y tengan su rúbrica. ¿Ya? ¿Any question? ¿Alguna consulta, chicos?
No, miss.
¿Alguna pregunta?
No, miss.
¿No? Ok.
No, miss. Ninguna.
Ya, chicos. Que tengan muy buena semana.
Y por usted, miss.
Okay, bye. Bye. Have a good day. Bye, bye.